ladies and gentlemen.
We're back.
We are back. First video of the new year.
It's the
Either Tire podcast, episode number 10. Thank you all for sticking with
number
us.
Number 10?
Number 10. Mad. Big number 10. The Fulham match day vlog didn't go up. Oh, why, Joe? Because, quite simply, when I edited it, it took forever. Two, it wasn't a game that I was particularly proud of. But we'll get onto that in a bit. So,
yeah.
The last game we reviewed was all the way back in like October when we played Derby and Fulham.
So we've got a lot to get.
Because we did the Christmas episode, didn't we?
Yeah.
Just to address the Christmas episode, basically it was around the time that my PC went bust. So, and all my editing software is on my big computer. Obviously, I'm not going to have it on my laptop. So what I had to do was I had to look round for cheap editors, which I could just slap it on. And I got it out. Yeah, it had the watermark on it, but I'm not paying. I'm not being funny. I am not paying £49 just for editing software, which I'm going to use once. So sorry, you lot.
But we're on a budget.
And it hadn't been my birthday then, so I wasn't paying for Adobe Premiere Pro on my laptop.
Mad.
And as well, signed Eye of the Tiger podcast posters. A couple of them have been distributed. I've got mine up there.
Nice.
There's two who haven't got back to me about anything, so please, Jamie Shin's Tea and Izzy and Reese's Dart channel, if you're watching, message me on Instagram, the link's down there, or message Ethan. Ethan can sort it out. But other than that, and if you don't message me, by the way, your posters are getting sent to someone else.
Yeah.
Because we've had plenty of requests for people who want them. Because what I've done is, on the Eye of the Tiger podcast story last couple of days, I've put on loads saying, run and get your posters!
Yeah, so listen.
Anyway, did you have a good Christmas?
Yeah, it was very nice, except I got ill. But what can you do?
What can you do?
Nothing.
Anywho, we've got a new piece of kit. If it hasn't worked, it's because my PC's broken again. So, sorry, but you will probably get new audio.
Better.
Better quality.
How much was it?
It was... Bloody hell. My watch has just fallen off my desk. It was about It was just over £100.
What?
But I'm going to use this for other videos and everything else like that. If you do sometimes see me in the podcast now putting headphones on, it's because I'm trying to monitor the audio. Honestly, you trying to do that is picking up so, so sensitive. It's insane. So in the future as well, I am going to get like two headphone jacks so both me and Ethan can monitor our audio. But once again, we are on a budget. So, even though they're 99 pence, I'm going to hold out and buy one for now. Anyway, let's crack into it. Middlesbrough away, what a shambles.
I don't really know. Is that the one where someone got a red card?
Yeah.
Yeah, I watched the red card and that was about it.
What a shambles of a game that was. I did some maths the other night. All the stupid points we've dropped this season, if we didn't drop them, we'd be third.
Mad.
It's unbelievable. But, yeah, Middlesbrough away was an absolute shambles. And I'll tell you what, one thing I took away from that game. Josh Bowler, if he had better decision-making...
He'd be class.
He would be class. Because, honestly, at the back post, Lewis Potter was stood unmarked. Bowler was looking... He just didn't cross it. He just kept running. When Lewis Potter could have smashed it in and won us the game. But anyway, moving away from that... We then had Preston at home, a 4-0 thumping. It was an absolutely brilliant game.
Wasn't there, but...
I mean, you've
seen the highlights.
You've been to games that I've not been to. Are you going to the Chelsea one?
Yeah, I'm in the Chelsea and the... Because I've got a membership, haven't I? £6.
£6, I know, yeah. It's mad, isn't it? I was looking at ticket availability the other day.
How much is it for a city ticket?
£6. E2 and 3, the East Corner, they've been completely sold out. There's not a single ticket left. And you know, right near the subs benches as well, like all that bit, they're completely gone as well.
Yeah, because everyone wants to see, like, Abraham's.
Everyone thinks, oh, Jared Bowen, when he's on the bench, he'll come take photos. No, he won't. He'll be watching the game.
He won't be on the bench. I think they'll play him. Imagine if he scores an hat trick.
Mate. Anyway, so after Preston, what was a brilliant win, I said it to Lewis, Gordon, my dad, my granddad, whoever we sit with, that we'll go to Barnsley and get battered. What happened? We went to Barnsley and got battered.
What score was it?
3-1. If I remember correctly, it was 3-1 or 2-1.
Yeah, I didn't keep up with many of the games over Christmas.
But a silver lining from that, it was the emergence of Keane Lewis Potter.
I know the results from, I know Leeds, Forest, QPR, Sheffield Wednesday, Rotherham, Fulham derby.
Right, yeah, we got beat 3-1 by Barnsley, but Lewis Potter scored his first goal. Then we went to play Stoke, where we were absolutely crap in the first half. But yeah, we turned it around with a Jared Bowen brace.
Yeah, because there was playing him striker and he didn't like it. So he went back out onto the right and he banged two.
Honestly, where would we be without that man?
I'm going to try this. I don't know. Whoa.
I know, it's good, isn't it? Where would we be without that man?
I do not know. We would be in League 2 fighting to stay in the actual Football League. Then,
yeah. Anyway, after that, we went and played the White Shite at Ellen Road.
Demonetised.
I'm gonna be honest.
It was rubbish.
To be fair, all they did, they just blocked out Bowen and Grzycki. Luke Ayling just marked Grzycki out the game. Stuart Dallas just marked Bowen out the game. So we had to be direct. We couldn't use the wings. We had to play through the middle. And we had Tom Eaves up. And we had Tom Eaves, for Christ's sake.
Never a good sign.
So, you know, you've got to kind of use the wingers when you've got Tom Eaves up front.
Yeah.
Maybe not when you've got Keane Lewis Potter up, because he's...
I don't get why we aren't playing him.
He's 3'4", and he's got the leap of flipping Tom Daly.
Yeah, Malik Wilkes. He's... That's a bit of pace up front that we need.
I tell you what, right? That Leeds game, we didn't play badly.
The second goal was unfortunate, wasn't it?
The first one was unfortunate. Device couldn't do anything.
Mm.
But then the second one, George Long made an absolutely class save. What does Bamford do? Just knees George Long in the head when he's trying to get up.
I don't like Bamford. Since he was at Chelsea, and I thought, you know, he could be good. State him now. He just
died. Smashed it out of Boron for the first time, didn't he?
Yeah.
Then he couldn't do it in the Premier League.
Nope. Because he's rubbish.
I tell you what, where that's from. I got a chair for Christmas. My sister's broken that. She kept unclipping it, thinking she's hilarious. And it broke. It just snapped on her.
That is not so good. How much are these chairs?
200 quid.
Bloody hell.
200 quid, but they're bloody comfortable.
Sleep on it.
I swear I have. Anyway, moving on from...
Leeds away.
My whole city coloured chair.
Yeah.
Charlton away. To Tim. So, we were appalling in the first half, yet again.
As usual.
But, straight out the blocks... We come out flying. Jared Bowen, 2 minutes into the half, smacks it in.
For 1-0.
For 1-1.
Oh, was it 1-1?
Yeah, because Darren Prattley scored.
In the first half.
Honestly, I was sat watching that game thinking, we are absolutely atrocious.
Yeah, we are.
And then Charlton replied with Naby Sarr.
Who's it?
Exactly. So at that point, I was sat to my dad thinking, why on earth are we watching this? Why on earth are we watching this?
But then
Keane Lewis Potter came on for Callum Elder. He took Tom Eaves. It says a lot when he's taking Tom Eaves off when we're 2-1 down, doesn't it?
Yeah, it says a lot.
And I tell you what, it's absolutely criminal that this has gone down as it has, but Lewis Potter put it in the 96th minute.
Oh, Oh, I was watching that actually, I remember.
But it went down as a Dylan Phillips own goal. Because Lewis Potter, what happened was he hit it, the keeper saved it onto the post, and then it dribbled across the line, and as the keeper was following through, it hit his back. So it went down as Dylan Phillips' goal. When that got announced, Lewis Potter just said, well, I'll have to score another one then. then we played Birmingham. We were absolutely class against Birmingham. We were absolutely class. Tom Eaves scored.
Saying something.
Tom Eaves, Kamil Grzycki, and Keen Lewis Potter. See, this is when Bowen went in a bit of a bad patch of form.
He still is.
Yeah, he is, to be fair.
Since him and Jazz broke up.
He's not been the same.
We need to get him a pint. Tell him if he don't play, he's going to leave.
Look, we'll ring him up. We'll get him a Hull City's number one fan mug of water. Or a glass of water in Ethan's case.
Exactly.
And we'll just sit there and say, look,
Jared, if you don't start performing, you're coming down with us.
We'll get on to transfer rumours about Jared in a bit, because we've nearly finished all the games now.
Yeah.
But we were pure class against Birmingham. We were absolutely brilliant. Leonardo da Silva Lopez ran that midfield like a prime...
N'Golo Kanté.
N'Golo Kanté.
He is. He's a championship N'Golo Kanté.
Then it got to Boxing Day. Merry Christmas, everyone. We get loads of them. It's a bloody bug.
Yeah, well...
It was safe to say...
We were appalling.
I mean, it didn't help that Forest were...
Good.
Well, no, they weren't even that good.
Lewis Graban. That's the problem.
He wasn't even good. He scored. But then after that, they just laid down on the floor. So I got abuse in my comments section as well from that vlog. I got absolutely mullered.
Why? Oh, bye.
Forest fans.
Oh, I know, you were showing me all.
Said, you moaning about Sam Bassur going down three times. That's the guy who got fouled for the penalty and then went down twice before they brought him off. You moaning about Sam Bassur going down three times is hilarious. He went down and was then subbed off in the 40 minute because of an injury that he picked up when he was fouled for the penalty. I replied, but surely when he went down the second time, your physio must have that thing called common sense and thought he can't go on. So road to 25 million subscribers. He's on...
Never gonna happen.
Three. He said, you're getting mauled by the Lewis.
Who's Lewis Graber?
C-O-Y-R.
Come on, you.
I don't care.
What's the R for?
I don't have a clue and I couldn't really care.
Come on, you.
How ironic. How ironic calling us chests. I assume he means cheats. When you did it to us at our ground and that was a clear penalty.
Being free. What score was it?
2-1.
2-1.
Because we were on about. Because we read it on the podcast, our conversation, didn't we? Josh McGinnis and Big Bertie Balog. So I said, the lad who went down at your place hasn't played since, just came back after an injury and actually got injured.
Who? Terrell?
No. Balog. Because he went down in the 89th minute, didn't he?
Yeah.
No, but Balog hasn't played since then. And I tell you what, their goalkeeper, after City fans were giving Forrest abuse for just cheating.
Yeah.
Like, there was a point where Joe Lolley was a metre away from the sidelines and just stayed sat there on the pitch. If you're properly injured and you want the game to go on, you will roll off that pitch.
Yeah.
So he said, so he tweeted a photo of Balog on the floor and said, remember this. So every City fan was just giving him dogs abuse. I even said something on Twitter as well. Because honestly... How a player can get involved in a debate like that, it's just beyond me.
It's beyond me as well.
I'm trying to find where it was. Somewhere around here. Merry Christmas, Hull City. So Samba, so Bryce Samba replied to Sam Overton saying, Nottingham's physios must be tied running onto the pitch every 2 minutes. Cheats. Bryce Samba tweeted this photo with the caption, remember. So, Sam Overton replied, you fucking idiot. Remember what exactly? Our debutant who recovered from a long layout needing treatment because you tried dragging him off the pitch. Also, if it was time wasting, at least we didn't do it from minute one like you boring bastards.
Oh, blah, 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 blah. Fat wound.
Someone said, well, a Forest fan said, you're taking a fat L here. Sam Overton replied, how's that then? Our player Bollock hasn't been available for 2 months since that injury. He's made no valid point whatsoever. Just living off the Forest support, sucking his cock. I replied, a debutant who just came back from a long injury life and hasn't played since that game. Nice of you to admit why you did it, though. I also said, I remember this, the lad hasn't played since then, so he was 100% time-wasting, wasn't he? You effing div. Anyway, rant over. QPR! George Hunt, did you see George Honeyman when he scored? He didn't know what to do!
Wasn't it away, though?
Yeah, it was away. But he was just running about. He didn't have a clue what to do.
Scissor kick in the air.
Poor fella. But yeah, 2-1 win. Irvine and Honeyman scored. After we did go down 1-0, though.
But we did bring
Stephen,
it back.
Well, in the Forest game, Callum Elder got injured.
And then Kingsley.
And then Stephen Kingsley got injured in the QPR game and got the exact same injury.
It's mad, isn't it? Elder's back then, aren't
we? Elder's back. But successful result. Then we got 2 away wins on the bounce.
Absolute quality.
We beat Sheffield Wednesday 1-0. We love that scoreline, don't we?
Yeah.
Big up the army.
The army.
The army.
The army.
The army.
Really in. Then.
The army. I was just ear raped you all, sorry.
Then. Not Chef Wednesday, the FA Cup.
The FA Cup.
The Jungle Cat.
Against Rotherham. It would be against the League One team, but Tom Eves scores a hat-trick, though.
The Jungle Cat himself. Tom Eves.
The cat that got the cream.
What a man.
I mean, we did go down 1-0. You had Rotherham fans complaining on Twitter that the reason their guy was sent off, it wasn't a red card. But literally, like, it was a tackle on Keane Lewis Potter. He had studs up challenge to the knee.
Yeah, it was bad.
And he could have ended Keane Lewis Potter's career before it's even started.
Exactly. And if he did, he would have got one of them.
I know, because he's our best hope. When Jared leaves,
yeah, we're going to need inevitable.
Him. It is inevitable. I mean, we said it in episode 4 that, because we got a question, would Jared still be here in a year? I said yes, you said no.
He won't be. Unless we get playoffs this season. I think if we get playoffs and we don't get promoted, it will stay.
Realistically, though, this team ain't good enough to go up. Exactly. This team isn't good enough to go up.
If we went up, we would get 0 points in the Premier League.
To be fair. Right, anyway. Chelsea. But Tom Eves.
Oh, sorry.
Brilliant. Then there was the FA Cup draw. Chelsea in the FA Cup.
What more could you want?
My instant reaction to that was...
ring. Yes, no.
It was... Because normally we're waiting forever. It was, oh yes, oh no. And then I just rang Tilly because she's a Chelsea fan. Yeah. So I was like, actually, previews and that, we'll be back for the Chelsea game.
Hey!
Hey! Hey! I've got 2 Chelsea fans helping me out with a preview.
Who?
I've got Tilly doing a little preview. And then I've got someone who I know... from doing this whole YouTube thing, doing a few little clips as well. Yeah, I've got all Tilly's vlog graphics saved on, not vlog graphics, preview graphics saved on there.
I'll be in the Chelsea stand, giving it the big
one. Giving it to the
big Harvey Gibbons.
Is Gibbo in E2?
Yep, that's where we usually are.
Anyway. After that, we played Fulham. I'm going to be honest. We mentioned it earlier. Shocker. We were just a shambles.
Right. Tom Eves, in the first 10 minutes, that chance he had. one-on-one, 6 yards out.
He thought it was offside. I tell you what, the liner was absolutely clueless.
Yeah, the ref knew it wasn't offside, so he didn't blow his whistle, did he?
But Eves did. And I tell you what,
play to the whistle.
The most bizarre thing, it was in the second half. Jordy Device got fouled by Cyrus Christie. The ref initially gave a free kick, gave him a booking. But then the liner on the other side, he's there with his flag up for offside. So then we're thinking, so I say, what the bloody hell's this liner doing? So, but then the ref, he overturns the yellow card and the free kick for offside.
Crazy business.
Oh my god.
It's madness.
VAR,
that's what we need.
Tell you what, we need VAR for the VAR circle, for the VAR squares that the referees draw. Because some of them are circles, I swear.
Yeah, they've
just got that, don't they? Anyway, so after that, I tell you what we need to touch on as well. Mitrovic. Jordy Device got in his head from minute one, and I absolutely love him.
Yeah.
But then when Mitrovic won't get... Right, you know when Mitrovic got injured?
Yeah.
The first time, he stood on Lehigh.
Yeah, I know, that's what I said too.
He stood on Lehigh. Like, you were sat just pretty much opposite it, weren't you? I was sat at the other end of the ground, and I could see that Mitrovic stood on Lehigh. So Mitrovic went off, came back on, moved 2 yards, fell to the floor again.
Yeah, I was saying, how can this big Serbian blur...
And you had all the flipping old blokes sat above me shouting, get him off the you bitch, you intosser!
In A2, it's lovely.
Anyway, after that, you went to Derby.
Yep.
Do you want to give us a rundown on the game?
Well, great atmosphere, although I must say, poor stadium quality, card machines don't work.
I
did not eat between the hours of 11 o'clock in the morning about 9 o'clock at night because of Derby. So anyone from Derby watching this, you owe me a burger and chips.
Maybe a bottle of Coke as well.
Yeah. Right, so we started off well. From kickoff, we even had a shot, or maybe a cross, one of the two, but it was going good and we was battering them all game. Bowen misses from 6 yards out, absolutely shocking. Ball falls to him, half volley on his left foot, 6 yards out.
That's his bread and butter.
Exactly, and he puts it wide. But there was a lot of positives. You know, Herbie Kane, he ran the midfield.
What did you think of Wilkson Samuelson when they came on?
They didn't really touch the ball that much. Samuelson, he's shown what he can do. He absolutely sent Tom Huddleston to the cleaners with a bit of skill.
To the hairdressers, am I right?
Three of them cornered him, little Cruyff turn, drag back, straight through all three of them to get his way out. Wilkes looked like he had brought a bit of pace to the team, but we didn't really see much of him because he wasn't getting the ball. And then the goal, all I can say is George Long is a fool.
He's a fool! You are nothing! You are a fool and you are a waste of time! Good night!
Have you seen the goal?
No.
So, corner's whipped him. The man who headed the ball in was on the penalty spot.
Yeah.
And there's about 5 players of both teams, not 10 players, but like 5 players of mixed, in between George Long and that player.
Yeah.
So George Long just runs out his goal to try and get it and was probably about... if you put another arm on his arm, he was probably that far away, so like... It was probably about this far away from the ball and it just went into an empty net. And then last 2 minutes, I think, Elder, literally the easiest ball ever down the line to Wilkes, and then we've got like a 3-on-2 to equalise in the 94th minute, and he literally kicks it probably
into row Z.
Yeah. It didn't go high, it just went very, very wide of Wilkes. So it was disappointing, I cannot lie.
Anyway, right.
Six minutes. We can get it done in 6 minutes.
So, Herbie Kane, Samuelson and Wilkes have signed. I think they'll all be decent signings. Obviously, all there because of Grant McCann.
Yeah.
But the thing I like about it is he's bringing in players that he knows, not just players he's taking a stab in the dark. Look at Tom Eves.
Yeah.
Other rumours that we've had Lyndon Dykes.
Abel.
We'll get onto Abel in a minute. That's a whole separate segment.
We've had Ukwuoke from Chelsea.
Owakwe.
Owakwe, however you say it.
Tariq Owakwe.
He's a good player.
Brandon Fleming's gone out on loan.
You know, big up.
We're looking to get rid of Dicko. That'll be three clubs in for Dicko in one season.
Ah.
We're looking to offload Henriksen. His boyhood club are interested. And Milinkovic. If any team wants Davy Milinkovic, we're going to let him have him for free.
We'll pay you to have him.
Literally. Right, we'll talk about Jared Bowen for a bit.
Not looking good, is it?
And I read today that Tottenham are going to put a £20 million bid in.
And Ehab will not let that go. £20 million.
Imagine being back up to Harry Kane.
Nah, he'd be back up to Son, wouldn't he? And Mora.
No, but the way I've read it, the way I've said it is, Mourinho is going to bring him in as back up to Harry Kane.
And if he signs, this January transfer window, he'll be playing for the next 2 months in the Prem.
Oh, I know he will be. Other interests, Wolves, Aston Villa, Newcastle. We need to talk about Leeds United especially. Leeds United, message to you. What?
Die in a bin.
Yeah, just die in a bin. There's three of them out in my back garden. Go get in one of them. £3 million loan bid. £3 million.
Stupid.
£3 million. £3 million and £15 million if you go up. So it's just £3 million and wishing away our hopes of playoffs, really, isn't it?
Yeah.
Right. The camera's about to cut out, so. But the thing is, what's going to happen now is we'll have continued audio whilst the camera
has closed off.
I'm resetting it. So there we go, continued audio.
Woo!
Bada bum, bada bum, bada bum. Injury news, we've had a lot of injuries, haven't we? But we're coming to the end of that now. Stuart's out the protective boot. Did you see his story the other day? When he got the in a bit, my guy.
Yeah.
Safe. Joking. I'll get told off.
That was good.
And what else happened? What do we want from this winger? I want a striker.
A fast striker, though. Not another Tom Eaves.
Not another Josh McGuinness. Not another Norbert Balog. We want someone little.
Little and quick.
Want someone.
Who's
little.
The guy from Preston? Maguire.
Sean Maguire, yeah.
He's decent.
Hashtag Adansa Bell. Ehab Alam saw our story on this.
He's the quick striker.
I mean, he'd still rip it up. There's people on Twitter saying, I just walked out with an Aldi and Anlaby and Abel and Anderson. That's BS.
Yeah, there's no way.
He literally posted a video of him training in Qatar that day.
And if you're a professional footballer,
you're not shopping in a blooming Aldi, are you?
Exactly. But hopefully.
Hopefully. But imagine the wages he'd be out on. He'd be on out there though. If we weren't accepting his wages when we let him go, he's not gonna want to come back now when we're giving him
less.
The same wage. Anyway, Max Sheaf and our guy Jacob extended loan at Cheltenham. And Jacob also got Player of the Month for December at Cheltenham. I sent him a little message. Well done, Jacob! Ear rape!
Brilliant from Jacob.
Sean McLaughlin got recalled. Yes! Let's get down to training ground. Let's go!
The Irish beast.
Tyler Hamilton extended his loan with Hartley Pearl.
Fair enough.
He was doing well out there. Will Mannion extended his loan at Kidderminster. Ehab Alam saw the podcast Instagram story yesterday. Max Clark and Billy Chadwick replied to us.
Brilliant, that's what we like to see.
I'll get it up now, actually.
Is Chadwick still like in the
academy? Yeah. So
big as a kingdom.
We sent a happy birthday story to Max Clark. He like replied within seconds. Up the Tigers.
UTT.
And I just replied, love that from you, Max. Then he got us on his story as well. And you know what? He'd be a brilliant podcast guest, wouldn't he?
Ah, Max Clark.
And then it was also Billy Chadwick's birthday that day as well. So, we got a Max Clark story. We got a Max Clark's Instagram story.
Exactly.
And Billy Chadwick, we put something on about Billy Chadwick and he said, cheers, mate. Little does he know we are an organisation. Said, have a good day, Billy, replied, will do. That's another good podcast guest, man.
Yeah.
He's one of the ones who saw all my initial messages, but didn't really care.
Yeah, Billy.
Update on...
To what?
Update on the other guest as well. Anyway, I'm going to whitter on about signed posters again.
Again.
Just needs to be done.
Who are the people that aren't replying?
Jamieson's T and Izzy and Reese's Dark Channel.
Izzy, Reese,
Jamie, Shins, T.
Get replying now.
Do you want one of these?
Because if you don't, someone else can have them. You ungrateful sods.
We've got people queuing up.
Yeah, we've got a queue.
Anyway, right, the Huddersfield game that we would play on the weekend has been moved to the Tuesday, so shall we preview the Chelsea game and the Huddersfield game briefly before we end?
Yeah, alright.
So,
we'll beat Huddersfield.
I'll stick the headphones on for this.
Tom Eves hat-trick against Huddersfield.
Can you imagine?
That is.
What is this? That's some, like, ASMR stuff, man. This is a whole city podcast, not ASMR.
Alright, yeah. I think we'll beat Huddersfield comfortably. This is what we usually do. We have a couple of games where we beat our batter teams. Then we lose a few games when we just get near the playoffs. Then we win some more games and get close to the playoffs. Then we lose some more games and get away.
Then we lose. But
listen to how loud this is. That's what you kept doing.
I know, it's loud, isn't it?
Yeah. Good audio quality, though.
I know, very good. Anyway, so... So, Huddersfield. Obviously, I'll have previews out for that, whatever.
Is it at home?
It is at home.
I'll be going to that then.
Oh, yes, Ethan.
That's all for season pass for the next year.
Is that what you've got?
Yeah.
Round of applause for Ethan. This is just ear rape again, but...
E2.
You're with the hard cars.
Exactly.
Then Chelsea, it should be a tough game. Obviously, yeah. Preview for that will be out on Friday. You'll have not only me doing stuff, you'll have Tilly doing stuff, and you will have someone else who's a surprise guest doing stuff as well.
Also, with the Chelsea game, you could say they'll play the youngsters, but bloody... The youngsters playing in the Prem, aren't they? It'll be like Pedro and stuff playing.
I know.
Maybe even Giroud.
Olivier Giroud.
Yeah, won't have a problem against him. It's rubbish.
I know. Johnny Device would batter, man. Right then, so should we... anything else you want to add?
Did you see what happened to the Fulham fan?
What happened to the Fulham fan?
There's this Fulham fan in Pinkston Island giving it the big one, saying, I'll see you outside. Some of the City fans got outside, wham, one punch, he was out. He was out for the count on the floor. And then he got up and he was like, I'm all right. And then bang, straight back down again. Did not end well.
In his Stone Island giving it hard.
And did you see the Fulham fans that got thrown out?
Yeah, they were. That was funny, that.
Yeah. And we made a Fulham fan cry. There was this Fulham fan giving it the big un, so there was some obscenities chanted at him, and he started crying.
Oh my god. anything else?
Derby was good, you know.
Derby was good.
Chanting about Andy Robertson.
Hey, see, my dad said that, had he thought about it, we should have gone to Derby, but he didn't think about it, and after the game, was like, my mum said, bet you're glad you're not gone to that one.
We saw them crying when Robertson scored. And that was the chant of the century.
Anyway, so that is the end of the longest
Eye of the Tiger podcast
episode to date.
Get ready for 34 minutes.
Get ready for 2020, because we have got...
It's going to be a big one.
I could hear that. Turn the volume up. Just talking to it.
Hello.
That is loud. Right, don't mute, you'll just cut out all this off here. Anyway, right, so that's the end of the Longest Eye of the Tiger podcast episode today. I've already said that. We've got a lot of stuff planned for 2020. We're going to get famous people on, we're going to get fans on. We might even try and get
a player.
A player. I've got my contacts.
He's got his contacts.
I know, I'm not keeping up, am I?
Ah, disappointing, Jersey.
So, yeah, right, that's the end. See you later. Bowie! Let's end it there.
Woo!